keep coming in.
It's cold.
Will you watch me just for a
How was your class today? Camilla?
It's Thursday, the class.
Suppose we'll spend the whole evening discussing Melissa Walmsley's dig. Fatal to invite anyone to dinner after they've just done something. Where was her bloody dig anyway?
In the city, I think.
In the city? God, if I was going to hunt for a megalithic fibula, I'd do it somewhere attractive.
Aren't you looking forward to tonight, Michael?
No.
They're your friends.
Yes. I just can't remember why they are.
Me. You would think that Rebarak was twinned with Crawley. Honestly, you take the K-wings to the pool and what are you forced to endure? Idiots in unmistakable M&S leisure wear screaming, "Go on, Darren, do another one for Dad."
Oh, well, Betty says she's had France. She says if she smells a Pernod, she'll vomit.
Well, avoid Dododoin like the plague. I tell you, it's not just Gibraltar and the Falklands that the British have colonised. Salad, darling?
Did I tell you that Grant's been chosen, Michael? We're ever so thrilled.
Chosen?
Not chosen as in chosen, darling. Yeah. Only to play pool.
Pool?
Yes, they're doing it at St. Cuthbert's, a dramatised version. Oh. And Grant's going to be the actual bear. We're terribly excited.
Oh, lovely.
Aren't we, Brad? I was just telling Michael, Camilla, that Grant's been picked to play pool, St. Cuthbert's play.
Well done.
Silly to feel pride, I suppose, but we just can't help it. Sign of age, no doubt.
Why age?
Well, starting to live your children's lives, you know. You know what I mean.
Oh, yeah.
How was the dig, then?
Oh, the dig. A bit disappointing.
No fibulas or tibulas?
Tibias, you mean. Yes. 13th, though, no earlier. Mm. Oh, there was evidence of Roman ducting, but of course we weren't able to follow it. The indications are the actual bathhouse could be situated under the Glen Eagles Bank.
Hey. I've never got it.
Got what, Betty?
Well, I mean, they say the Romans had loos in 49 BC or something, and it's taken us 1,700 years to invent them again.
No, 1900, actually. The first loo, as we know it, made its appearance in 1899.
And they say progress is continuous. Well, how many loos has the new house got, Michael?
What? Oh, two and a downstairs.
No.
So pines are fat of the past, then. All those butcher boxes that Betty's been turning into bedside tables. Not worth 2 and 6, eh?
No. I did not say that. What I did say was that I personally was getting out of pines.
Ah, sounds excruciating.
Yeah, but decorated wood, Dutch colonial Balkan style, hand-painted. That'll be the feel of the 80s. It's much more expensive.
You must all of you come round and see it. It's got a terribly pretty garden for London, hasn't it, Camilla?
What, Michael?
I'm talking about the new house.
Oh, the new house. Yes.
These estate agents always pocket the bargains, don't they, huh?
Super garden, I hear. Gosh, we envy you, don't we, Brad?
Oh, sure we do. It sounds like the kind of place we all dream about.
We dream the wrong things.
What, Camilla?
Delicious chicken, Camilla. Can I taste dill?
No, it's tarragon.
Michael.
Stop hating me. I love you so much.
How much? 5 bedrooms, 3 bathrooms, dining room, breakfast.
Can't believe it's the house. If we don't snap this up now, darling, we'll never be able to afford it again.
I don't want to afford it.
Jesus. Camilla, sometimes you make me feel so bloody sad. Laura?
Is that you, Michael?
Yes, of course it's me.
Oh, did I wake you?
Yes.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry, dear. I've just been sitting here, staring at the telephone.
It's your mother.
You know, I think I'm going absolutely mad.
What's happened, Laura?
Well, since I got back from the police station, I just sat here.
Oh, darling, you better speak to Camilla.
No, I don't want to wake her. It was just a question of speaking to someone, because, you know, honestly, Michael, I never in a million years imagined something like this could happen to me.
What has happened, Laura? Laura?
Well, I was in Harrods.
You were in Harrods?
And?
Well,
I thought I haven't eaten lobster since George died.
Lobster?
And there they were, that beautiful coral colour on a slab.
Lobsters?
Yes, so I just picked one up and took it along to where you're meant to pay, and well, then I decided not to.
You stole a lobster.
Yes. And then they unleashed it on me. The Holocaust.
My drying up cloth's awfully wet, darling. Where do you keep your clean ones? I do admire you and Michael keeping on with dinner parties. One thing I thought after George died was, thank God, no more dinner parties. Is it a success, the evening?
No.
Michael's a lovely host, I'm sure. Courteous, considerate. Of course, in your new house, you'll have a proper dining room.
17 foot into bay, part colour glazed window area.
What, darling?
I can't stop myself.
Stop yourself what?
I don't want to be here.
What do you mean, Camilla?
I want us to stop.
I do understand. You know, I've often thought everything's going wrong for no reason. Like mayonnaise curdling. Well, it passes. Huh? Take me, Camilla. I'd be no good at mail bags. What on earth did I do?
You won't get life, Mother.
I used to think, when I was young, rather fun to get arrested. Because it wasn't in the least.
Lots of women steal.
I know why they think, drat it, life's just gone.
Maybe.
They're right. It has gone. I suppose magistrates are kind.
Yes.
I could get a horror, couldn't I? I mean, a hanger and flogger. I think I ought to prepare myself psychologically for mail bearers.
Mother, don't be silly.
I can't remember what else one does.
What?
In prison. Did metal work or something?
I've no idea.
Oh, it's that cell business that I know I should hate. I'm so used to space.
Mother, you are not going to prison.
Food. I feel like going back to school.
What happened to the bloody lobster anyway?
Oh, I don't know. It's probably evidence by now. Label, put in a polythene bag and going rotten. Exhibit A. I loved its spikiness. I still think how lovely to have eaten it. Very male.
So I find myself back in London. Well, how are you then, lovely stranger? I've scoffed and scoffed at life, making marks on walls, making my little Don's noises, and here I am at 55, back in the filthy old city, remembering. You must be 35, if you were 20 then. Or were you older already and much too wise to mourn me? Yet I allowed myself the terrible luxury of imagining you weeping. I surrounded you with foliage like in the paintings of Rossetti. I wonder if you would see me. I so long for that, in the full and glorious knowledge that I don't deserve it. My vandal soul should be utterly punished. Yet the wife I left you for is no longer my wife. I'm what they call single again. I've stopped belonging. I've known much. Johnny and Brendan drop in when pieces start to fall off their lethal motorbikes. They'll both end up as raspberry jam on the M1, I'm certain of it. I still teach Yeats and live alone in the bee loud glade. But I miss you, sod it all. Please write to me. Yours in loving memory, Liam.
Oh, sorry, I just came to say I'm going out.
To your course?
Yes.
What have you got today?
Literature.
Did you learn that Yeats poem they set you?
Mm-hmm. Teresa helped me.
Why don't you say it to me?
Oh, no, no, it's no good.
Go on, please. I once studied Yeats. My teacher was Irish. Please, say the poem.
Oh, curl you, cry no more in the air, or only to the water in the west, because your crying brings to my mind patient dimmed eyes and long heavy hair that was shaken out over my breast. There is enough evil in the crying of the wind.
Yes, I remember it. Are you meeting Teresa from school?
Yes, we are going to buy records.
Are you?
Yes.
I don't buy records anymore. Nor does Michael. We just buy things to stare at. Sometimes I look at what we do and I realize we've become dull.
You grew up and alter.
Have you heard from your parents lately, Elise?
Yes, I did.
Are they well?
Very well, thank you.
Give them our love next time you
write. Okay.
Are you happy here, Elise?
Oh, yes, I like London.
Happy with us, I mean.
Yes, of course.
I'm so glad. Therese is very fond of you. Do you find her difficult to talk to?
I don't think so. To me, she isn't.
To me, she is.
A three-bedroomed property, formerly known as Unwin Cottage, now being offered in two lots. Unwin Cottage itself, with grounds to front, together with grounds to rear, to an area indicated as approximately 3/7 acre, these forming the perimeters of Lot 1A and Lot 1B, namely substantial grounds to rear, measured at 5/7 acre, with planning application as yet ungranted for the erection of three dwellings. Good. Well, before I open the bidding, I would like to remind you that the purchaser of Lot 1A is under no obligation to bid for Lot 1B. Likewise, Lot 1B may be obtained, Lot 1A having been sold to another bidder. Do we have any questions at this juncture? Yes, sir.
Do we know whether planning permission will definitely be granted for the garden?
For Lot 1B, you mean? We understand this is currently under review by Merton Council.
Are they likely to say yes?
Difficult to say at this moment in time, sir, but we at Stukeley's are currently optimistic. Good. I would like to open the bidding then for Lot 1A, Unwin Cottage. What am I bid? Do I hear 30,000? 35? 40? Do I hear 40,000? 45? 50? 50? 55? £55,000? 60? 65? 70? £70,000 for Unwin Cottage. 75,000 pounds. 72,500. Good for you, sir. 72,500. 75, then. I'd like to hear 75. 75 for Unwin Cottage. 75,000 for Unwin Cottage. 75, I'm bid. 75,500. 75,500? No. 75,000, then, for Lot 1A. 75 once. 75 twice. 75 three times. Down to you, sir.
Thank you. Ah, Mrs. Douglas. Aunt Trace is doing very well.
Oh, it's not so much a question of doing...
She contributes. That's 90% of what I look for.
Yes, I know that as far as lessons go, she's getting on all right.
Distresses her?
What?
Crying at bedtime, that kind of thing.
Oh, no.
Not a whiff of that in school. She's a popular girl, plenty of friends.
Yes, I know.
I often say to the kids, learn this now. You get out of life exactly and precisely what you put in.
Yes, I know.
Want to see her work? Nice stories. Plenty of humor.
I can't talk to her.
No?
No.
Your fault or hers?
What?
Communication. Difficult for a kid of Tracer's age. More often than not, it's the parents and not them. Had one boy in this class, wrote a story entitled What My Dad Says at Breakfast. It was a page of sighs and moans. And right at the end, bugger this for a start of the day. I gave him an A+.
A+?
Yes, for sheer bloody honesty. Now then, it's not talking. Tracer's problem are yours.
Thank you for your help.
That's all right. Anytime.
Where have you been?
In the garden.
In the garden.
I was watching you.
Peep show.
Michael, what do we say to each other at breakfast?
What?
What do we contribute to each day?
What the hell are you talking
about,
Camilla?
I've been walking.
What?
I was walking around and thinking about what we put into our lives.
You know, it's 5 to 8.
I mean, when did either of us really make anything you could call a contribution?
Contribution to what? I, personally, have given 12 quid this year to the SDP, 20 to the Mevagissey Lifeboat Disaster Fund. Shit.
I wish I had hair like yours.
Shall I dye it green? You look like a witch.
I used to believe in witches. But I didn't imagine them on broomsticks. I imagined them on parking meters.
They say all the romance has gone out of my generation. What?
Oh, never mind. What have you decided about Mummy?
I don't know. My mother had moons. She once threw an aubergine at our neighbor's dog and it died.
It died?
Yes, and my father has to pay for a burial.
But how could it die from aubergine?
I don't know. Sometimes things happen which you don't mean. The neighbor said we were a family of murders, and they sniffed at us if we met him.
Gosh. How lovely to have a real quarrel. A vendetta, like in Romeo and Juliet. I'd love to have a vendetta.
Shall we play the other side?
I think Mummy's having a nervous breakdown. Don't you?
I had a letter from Liam today.
Who's Liam?
Liam. The lecturer, the one I...
Oh. Him. Still teaching the D.H. Lawrence option, is he? Still interfering with the student body? Do you want a drink?
No.
Well, perhaps an aging Irishman, pretend poet, or whatever he imagines himself to be, is just the tool, Camilla.
What do you mean?
To prize you open. Or you could become a road mender.
What?
It suggested that women would cry less if they could dig holes. The Equal Opportunities Commission is said to be studying the prototype of a lightweight pneumatic
drill.
Shut
up, Michael! Shut up! Nobody listen! Nobody really listen!
Whole world is listening, Camilla! We're all agog! Just try to find out what it is you want to say! Turn them and cut him down! I'm sorry.
It's all right.
Drummy hearts, drummy fast, fear sure built into every wall.
Looking winter, through the glass, spring, sure summer, casual wear.
Looking out at the rain, looking in through the storm, treading the way, coming from harm. How could you regret your other world? Hoping for thrill.
Dear Liam, how extraordinary to get your letter. Of course I mourned you for a long time, but not with Rossetti's leaves around me. Then I decided to forget you and marry. These days I treat life with such solemnity. My life becomes less and less, and I look at it more and more gravely. I will see you, if it can be arranged secretly. I've never quite got over my childish love of secrets. They're such betrayals. I'd like to meet you where we used to meet when we were deceiving your wife. I'll be there on Thursday at 4 o'clock.
Bloody hard essay I found, my house subject. Couldn't find really how to write video cassette.
Oh, heavens no, I wouldn't know. And me, Bugsy Byler, you see, I made a guess. I tried to hear Bugsy Byler, but I could not hear how to write it. The beginning is very feeble, look. My house is a flat. It is very feeble.
My house is a flat? You can't say that, fella, bye.
How else can I start if my house is not a house?
Write an old saying. Dear teacher, this is one effing meaningless title.
Oh, my house is a flat, but I didn't put that in. I just described my husband's bed is hand-painted.
What about your bed, Dilsh?
That is my bed, my husband's bed and mine. I could have put.
Hand-painted, eh? Only the best for our Dilshad. None of mass-produced fibre board junk.
Hello, everyone.
Morning, everyone.
Morning.
How did everyone get on with my house essay? Carla, would you like to read us what you wrote about your house?
I heard a little struggle.
But you won in the end.
You see, in my house are very many people. I'm asking some of my sister's children to budge off so I can describe my house in peace. But they don't go.
Poor Jill. Are you happy to read it to us anyway?
Okay. I would like to say that in my house are many mansions, as do the Christians. But I am the opposite. My house is one part of a building. This building is called Waterloo Mansions.
Do you mean a flat, Tarla?
Yes.
Go on.
I and my sister Bapi spend all our day in this Waterloo Mansions house with Bapi's small children. The children play on a mauve carpet Bapi's husband buys us from Texas Home Care. I with Bapi stay mostly in our yellow kitchen. Our oven is Carida, secondhand. Bapi is very fond of marigold rubber gloves. Our house is never dry. My dear husband says, this damp is a bloody problem. My husband is right. I think this damp is a bloody problem because we spend almost £35 for wallpaper from Blunt and Sons, DIY specialists, and this will not stick and falls off. There is no garden. Bapi and I agree, if we had one garden, we would put our marigolds, the real ones, not the gloves.
Good, Darla. Excellent. Now, Squid, how about you? How did you get on?
It was raining, wasn't it, when you saw the house before? Camilla?
That woman's at the window.
Mrs. Everett?
Is that her name? She's watching us.
I expect, like me, she's trying to guess what you're thinking.
I want to cry.
What?
I've been hearing about a woman called Bapi, who lives in Waterloo Mansions with her sister and her husband, and her sister's husband and five children.
And every time they put wallpaper on...
Please stop it, Camilla.
Because the walls are so damp.
If you want to go and live with the underprivileged, please feel free to do so. Right now, I am offering you this house.
Mother says things go wrong for no reason. But there's always a reason.
Nothing's gone wrong, Camilla.
Yes, it has.
Then tell me what.
She's still staring at us.
Please tell me what's wrong.
I'll be like her.
What?
I'll be like her, like that woman. Like my mother going mad, saying, drat it, life's gone. I never even dared to look at what it was. Never further than what's comfortable and familiar and safe.
Camilla, part of looking at what life is, or whatever your phrase was, is not missing opportunities when they occur. And I know the house market. This property is underpriced by £6,000 or £7,000.
Can't buy your future.
This is a bargain, darling. An absolutely unmissable chance. And if we don't seize it now, it'll never, never happen again. In just a few months, weeks sometimes, when opportunities like this suddenly appear, and if you dither then, when you look up again, they're gone.
Please, let's leave.
What do you do with Jean-Paul?
What?
Tell me what it's like with Jean-Paul.
You mean?
Yes.
It's really nice.
Did it hurt the first time?
Not very badly.
Does he kiss you properly?
Yes.
When you see people on the television kissing, you can tell they aren't putting their tongues in.
I had a letter from Jean-Paul today.
Can I read it?
Well, he wants me to go home.
Don't, will you?
Maybe.
hello.
Well.
Well indeed. So this is her, is it? Mother and wife. Good Lord.
How are you, Liam?
How do I look?
Fine. Older a bit.
Older a lot. But I've gone off mortality as a set book. Well, beautiful creature. I'm dumbfounded to see you. Shall we go and glance at a brass rubbing?
If you like.
I don't particularly like. Why gaze upon history when today is gazing so delightfully on me?
Do you still write, Liam?
Poems or letters?
Poems.
Every leap year I write one.
Seriously?
Seriously. I get out my gnarled old pencil and an unlined sheet of recycled paper. Yes, Cleopatra. I do still write.
Is Granny to get put in prison?
No.
Why not?
Because she's done nothing wrong.
Mummy told me she stole something.
No. She forgot to pay for it.
That's the same thing, said in a posh way.
No, it isn't. Now, please eat your supper, Teresa.
Where's Mummy, Daddy?
I told you. She's with Granny.
Why?
Because your grandmother is upset about what happened.
And Mummy's upset.
What?
She's upset about everything.
What do you mean, Teresa?
She cries masses at the moment. Doesn't she?
Yes.
So she must be unhappy.
She's not unhappy, she's just...
What?
She's just tired. Now, please, eat your supper.
I've eaten it.
You never came to the house, did you? Hmm? Well, Anne took it. And every last stick and bauble in it. I said to my English chappy solicitor, what for the love of God is meant to happen to me? Husband and breadwinner for 16 years. Go on earning, he said. You have earning power and your wife, excuse me, your ex-wife has none at all. She has sacrificed her promising career as a tree surgeon to bear your foul-mouthed boys.
Thank you.
And now she must be justly compensated.
So you got nothing?
Law of the land said the lady takes it. Leaves the adulterous husband as old 78 and his grime copy of Ulysses. Why won't you talk to me, Egypt?
Because you're talking. Camilla? Michael? Darlings, are you in?
What are you thinking?
Why do people always ask each other that?
She's thinking he's not what he was. Lost his zap and his zip. And he drinks himself to Derry and back.
No.
What then?
I was imagining I was blind.
Blind?
Then things would seem to change less.
Where is she, Michael?
I don't know, Laura. She simply told me that you telephoned and asked her to stay with you till you felt calmer.
So unlike Camilla to lie. Do you think she's pregnant or something?
What?
Well,
Women do, when they're pregnant, start to be funny. No wonder, if you ask me. The idea of two heartbeats in one body was always a dreadful concept. They kept saying, do listen to it beating, and I had to tell them I honestly didn't want to. Of course, she could have had an accident.
She's got a coil, Laura.
I mean a road accident, on her way round to me.
But you said you didn't telephone her.
No, but I was going to ask if I could come round.
But you didn't.
No.
Then it wasn't you she's gone to see.
I suppose not. What on earth can we do? I would say call the police, if I wasn't one of the criminal classes now.
I think we should.
I'd give it a few hours yet. I mean, the sight of a uniform.
I'll give it till midnight.
Look, of course she could have come round to my house. Shall I dial my number?
Teresa told me she left at 4:15, Laura. Oh.
Yes, one must be rational. Think clearly. Like May Gray. Oh, my God, Michael, what a terrible week. Getting arrested and now Camilla walking the streets.
She's not walking the streets necessarily, Laura. She's probably gone round to a friend.
Yes, but which friend? Why? Don't suppose she's got a lover, do you?
No. Not Camilla.
Pusillanimous git that I was. Get the chance to make a good decision, and I make a rotten one.
How do you know if it was rotten?
Because we would have been happy, shot it. You and I.
Then?
Then?
Then, 15 years ago, we would have been happy.
You don't love me anymore, Egypt.
I remember that wretched Irish person. Not that I ever met him, I wasn't allowed to. Camilla was very ashamed of me in those days. She thought I was too old.
Too old for what?
To breathe. And she thought that everybody over 50 ought to snuff themselves out, playing Beethoven's Pastoral. Like poor old Edward G. Robinson.
What?
That terrible film where there was an overcrowded world and there was voluntary death. They called it Going Home. Do you know that Charlton Heston had never seen a daffodil. Oh, I mean, one might as well laugh. Camilla in Dublin, the magistrates tomorrow. Oh, my God, Michael, I do hope magistrates are people like me. And you, dear Michael, because in many ways we're very similar.
Been a bad one, is it, love?
What?
Evening didn't go too well.
No.
I didn't catch it, love, sorry.
Stop the car.
What, love?
Stop the car. How much is that?
280.
Okay, Charlie, Tango 85. 21 the number, got that? 21 Albert Mansions, name of Beverly.
Thank you very much.
Cross the road going to Ashley Gardens, Nell Gwent House going north, Crawford Street. Anyone for Nell Gwent?
Roger, Nell Gwent Baseball.
Well, we must wait for the future to show, said Mr. Banks, coming in from the terrace. It's almost too dark to see, said Andrew, coming up from the beach. One can hardly tell which is the sea and which is the land, said Prue. Do we leave that light burning, said Lily, as they took their coats off indoors. So with the lamps all put out, the moon sunk, and a thin rain drumming on the roof, a downpouring of immense darkness began. Nothing, it seemed, could survive the flood, a profusion of darkness, which, creeping in at keyholes and crevices, stole round window blinds, came into bedrooms, swallowed up here a jug and a basin, there a bowl of red and yellow dahlias, there the sharp edges and firm bulk of a chest of drawers. Not only was furniture confounded, there was scarcely anything left of body or mind by which one could say, this is he, or this is she.
Someone's fainted.
What's the matter?
Oh, someone's fainted.
Who is it?
Oh, God. Do you want to open the door?
God.
Bang it.
Oh,
it's stuck.
Oh, listen. Go and get this thing.
Somebody's gone to get the attendants. All right, you just wait. Where is he?
Mummy! Point it back there, ladies. Come out, Anna. Come out. Come
here.
Somebody give me a towel, please.
Can't you eat a tray, sir?
Got a pain.
Well, don't eat it, darling. Doesn't matter. I tell you what, now that Granny's not going to be sent to prison, why didn't you come and stay for a few days and we could all go out somewhere
no.
and give Mummy a writ of arrest?
No, I don't think so, Laura. I think Camilla needs us, all of us. I think she needs her family.
She needs rest, Michael. That's what Dr. Norton said.
Not only rest, Laura. If we all desert her.
Such a pain, Granny.
Have you, darling? Alice, what about popping upstairs with Teresa and I'll make her a hot water bottle?
Sure, you'll feel better in bed.
Hmm? And if you're fine tomorrow, we'll all go out somewhere. On a picnic, huh?
Alice come.
Of course you can.
Good night, darling. I'll come up and see you. And don't forget your teeth.
It's all so peculiar, Michael. Camilla's such a strong person. I've never known anything like this happen.
It's my fault.
Of course it isn't.
I've been trying to push her in directions she didn't want to go.
What directions?
New house. Grander way of life. She didn't want it.
But the new house was lovely.
I know. But she was right. We didn't need it.
I don't think it's the house. I think it's that wretched Irish poet.
Oh. He may be part of it. But visiting the past now and then isn't such a bad idea.
I think you're very tolerant. You don't suppose she slept with him, do you?
I don't know, Laura.
Well, if I was married to you, Michael, no, I don't mean that. I mean, if I was married to someone as kind as you, I wouldn't think of betraying that kind of kindness.
What kind of kindness?
Yours.
I loathe myself sometimes, Laura. I loathe what I do, what I wear. I'd like to betray me.
Don't be silly, Michael.
No, honestly, I would.
Then indeed peace had come. Messages of peace breathed from the sea to the shore, never to break its sleep any more, to lull it rather more deeply to rest, and whatever the dreamers dreamt holily, dreamt wisely, to confirm. What else was it murmuring, as Lily Briscoe laid her head on the pillow in the clean, still room and heard the sea? Through the open window, the voice of the beauty of the world came murmuring, too softly to hear exactly what it said, but what mattered if the meaning were plain? Entreating the sleepers, the house was full again. Mrs. Beckwith was staying there, also Mr. Carmichael. If they would not actually come down to the beach itself, at least to lift the blind and look out.
Come in.
I'm sorry to disturb you, Mum.
Come and sit down, darling.
Are you definitely going to be all right?
Yes.
Mummy?
Yes, darling.
It's begun. The thing.
What thing?
My periods.
Well done, baby. Grown up woman, eh?
could stand that, darling.
I'm all right.
It was so odd when I came round in the changing rooms. I kept hearing a voice, just like Mr. Ramsay in To the Lighthouse, reciting bits of the Charge of the Light Brigade. Someone has blundered.
I feel so worried, Camilla.
No, don't be.
I feel as though I'm at an exam and they've given me the wrong paper and I can't answer one question.
Did you know Teresa's periods have started?
What? Have they? Is she all right?
Yes. I feel so joyful for her. Because becoming a woman is so difficult and yet so amazing. And I want to tell her not to get snagged up in possessions and places and things. All you do is die in them.
I telephoned Mrs. Everett and told her we didn't want the house. I thought that might be a start.
This is our last class till the autumn.
We shall miss you, Camilla, and this very nice class.
I shall miss you.
But thank we you. Must go on again in September, won't we, Camilla?
Yes, of course, sir.
Because I'm reading a book to my son last night. Me reading in English to my son. And in this child's book, there is a creature who asks itself what it is. What am I, it says.
I'm a pink toothbrush, you're a blue toothbrush.
And I see her one very important question. Because I read these words, what am I, without any hesitation. When only a few weeks ago, I could not read one single word. So if now I can read this universal question, so I connect that in a matter of time, I shall be able to read anything in this language, and my understanding will grow larger.
It's important to be able to imagine progress.
No, Camilla, I see clear as daylight. Me reading these great words, and then when I've come to this far point in my reading, I'll become very much wiser. And not say to my wife, don't put the Rexco in the Baxi boiler. But who are you, wife? And who are we in life's journey?
Please let us go on with the class, I hear.
No, you must all start to ask these kind of questions, Dilshan. You must stop all this marigold gloves, Persil and Vim nonsense. Stop all of that. You must say to yourself, I'm not going to live this very bad diet of Cushion Flow and Mr. Kipling.
Correct, correct.
I'll sit in the black mud of all these Rexco nuts and dream topping. Till I can rise up and say, what am I?
Oh, Zahir, if this was simple.
Rise up out the dreams up and bloody
hell. No, I think Zahir is right.
Oh, Zahir is ignorant of money.
Mr. Kipling.
I teach my children that life is not only about space invaders.
And here is my beginning, you see, Camilla?
Yes, of course, sir.
You're wasting time, Zahir.
And ever since I saw my beginning, I've been so much a happier man.
Why does this silly, happy man waste time? Please, can we go on?
We are on, foolish Dilshan. In my way, we are on.